core stability session as part of my yoga restore. So it's really important that we have strong abs. It can help alleviate back pain, stabilizes the core, the pelvis, really good for your posture, great for your endurance, and even just basically tiring out as you do things throughout the day. Stronger the core, better your foundational work and everything is going to go the rest of the time. So you definitely need a yoga block. If you don't have one, get a beach towel or something that you can wrap up. We're going to be trapping, using the block to kind of trap between the elbow and the thigh and do a whole bunch of stuff. So it would be really good if you had a yoga block. So let's just do a little bit of warm up. And we'll start with empty coat sleeves. So just bring your feet about hips width, slight bend in the knees, and just begin heels down. Just begin to swing your arms around. I'm kind of slapping my hip with the opposite hand. And then I'm going to begin to lift that heel, have a nice bend in my knees, and just kind of twist. So the core, we've got your upper abs, your lower abs, you've got your obliques, you've got your low back. It's all part of the core. Can't think of our core just being the six pack. So in this session, we're going to work the whole thing. A couple things we want to keep in mind is we want to work real slow, and we want to maintain our breath. You never want to hold your breath when you're doing any core work. So a little bit more here. Take some inhales and some exhales. You can breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth for this entire session. This is not going to be the type of yoga session you're going to want to do like right before you go to bed. It's going to be pretty energizing. So let's inhale our arms up overhead, interlace all 10 fingers, release your pointer fingers, and just kind of move your pelvis around, make some circles, stop in the middle, Chandrasana, crescent moon, just bend over to the side. So I'm reaching to the left. I'm bumping my right hips over to the left and keeping my left side body really, really open and arcing. Take an inhale at the top and exhale up and over to the other side. Lift your chin away from your throat. Squeeze your thighs, squeeze your ankles, and then come back up to the center. Just going to turn backwards, bring your hands to your hips, to your low back, top of the glutes, your fingertips face down. Let's do what we call a backward bend. I like to say be the strongest spine in the room. So engage your abs, press your glutes forward, pull your elbows together, pull your chin back like you're pulling it back on a table. Lift the crown of the head, reach, 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 and then inhale the arms up. And let's do a forward fold. Just forward fold down. Come more kind of to the top of your mat. Grab opposite elbows and just sway. Release the head, neck, and shoulders. Release the fingertips down. Walk your fingers over towards one heel. Spider curl the fingers back to the center. Back towards the other heel. Walk the fingers back to the center. Lift one foot and step way back. So I've got my right foot back, my right knee down, my left foot is in front. So crescent lunge. I'm just going to bring my hands to my hips, and I'm just going to press forward, get a nice big hip flexor stretch here, and I'm just going to lift the front toes and get a hamstring stretch. I'm going to lift my arms up. I'm going to do a hip flexor stretch here and bring my fingertips to the mat. Shift my hips back, lift my toes. So step the foot down, lift the arms up, pelvis comes forward, belly is in, fingertips down. And then pause here in your crescent lunge. I'm gonna lift my arms up. My left foot is forward, so I'm gonna reach my left arm back towards my left, towards my back thigh or my back calf. I'm gonna lift and twist. And then come back towards the center. I'm gonna open twist both ways. So it doesn't make a difference. Just twist your arms open, lift your arms up, and then twist to the other side. And then plant your hands and step forward, down forward fold again. So you can grab your opposite elbows, you can bring your fingertips down. Maybe bend one knee, straighten the other. And let's go to crescent lunge on the other side. So I'm stepping my left foot back, my right foot is forward, my left knee is down. I'm gonna lunge. Ooh. With a big inhale. And then I'm gonna lift my toes, push through my heels, bring my fingertips down, and reach my hips back. Then I'm gonna step down and reach and lunge forward. A couple times, back and forth. Inhale, come up. Exhale, come down. Bend your knees as much as you need to. We're just waking up the hamstrings, waking up the back of the body, and then find your nice static lunge. My right foot is forward. I'm gonna reach back with my right hand. I'm reaching either for the heel, the calf, the hamstring, and I'm gonna lift the other arm up. And then I'm gonna come back towards the center and open my arms wide, and I'm gonna twist and open. Ooh. Watch your stability. Try to keep your shoulders right over your hips. And then come forward and twist to the other side. Good, and then inhale your arms up. And exhale, bring your hands down to the mat and step back to downward facing dog real quick. Walk your feet up behind your hands, hands to hips, and slowly rise to stand. So let's come to horse pose. So our toes are out and our heels are in. Bring hands to heart center. We're gonna lower the hips, flare the knees out towards the toes, and then lift, arms up, look up, and then come down. Just inhale and exhale. And then we're gonna start warming up our obliques. So come up, come to sink down into your nice deep horse squat. Bring your fingertips behind your head, but don't clasp your hands. Elbows are nice and wide. So you're just gonna dip your elbow towards your thigh and come up. And dip your other elbow down towards the thigh and come up. What you want to avoid is you want to avoid tilting forward. So it's like you're leaning your back up against a wall. So you only want to come down as far as you can. Draw your belly button in. Nice big breaths. Now I'm going to pause to one side and just bring my forearm right down onto that quad. And reach the other arm up. And a nice big stretch. And I'm going to cycle over to the other side. Forearm onto the thigh. Reach the arm up. And then release and face the front of your mat and press back into downward facing dog. Bend one knee, bend the other knee, walk your dog. Your biceps are right by your ears. You're looking back between your toes. Lift one leg up real high. So I'm lifting my right leg up all the way to the sky. I'm gonna shift forward to one-legged plank. So I wanna shift forward so that my shoulders are right over my wrists. I'm gonna bring my knee to my elbow, right knee to my right elbow, and then I'm gonna kick back up. And then I'm gonna come to the middle and bring my knee towards my nose and round my spine. I'm gonna kick back up, three-legged dog. Now I'm gonna shift to the other side and bring my right elbow, right knee to my left elbow, give it a kiss. Then I'm gonna step my foot through and drop my hips down, lower down onto my forearms, and just have a nice big stretch here. Make sure you're breathing. And you're going to bend that front knee, come up onto your hands, reach back up, three-legged dog, and then lower. Let's do the other side. Lift the left leg high, shift forward, left knee, left elbow, give it a kiss, give it a pause, inhale, reach high, three-legged dog, come forward, knee to the nose, round through the spine, back heel is really high, inhale, lift the left leg high, left knee, right elbow, give it a kiss, and then step through and lower down. Try to square your shoulders to the front of your mat and just lower down onto your forearms. So we're going to get right into this abdominal work right away. So make sure you're breathing. I'm going to teach, and I'm going to tell you guys either level 1 or level 2. There's no nothing wrong with staying at a level one in any of these poses. I would highly encourage you to do so if level two makes you break your form, which is what we don't want you to do. Your abs are never going to be any stronger if you push yourself up to too high a level. You don't master each step prior. So we're going to work on that today. So let's press ourselves back up. I'm going to find downward facing dog. So now I'm going to lift my right leg high. I'm going to pendulum swing. I'm going to come forward to my one-legged plank. I'm going to bring my right knee towards my right elbow, and I'm going to twist it over to my left elbow, and then back to my right. Pendulum swing. I'm breathing, and I'm swinging. Slight bend in the elbows. I'm pressing through my hands, and I'm doming through my upper back, through my shoulder blades. And then press back, and come to downward facing dog. Let's do the other side. Lift the left leg high, shift forward so that the shoulders are over the wrists, slight bend in the elbows, pendulum swing, side to side. Pull up on the knee to the elbow, pull up. Swing it from side to side. Four, three, two, one. Drop your knees down, knees are wide, big toes touch. Child's pose. So arms out in front. Knees are wide, big toes touch. Connect with your breath. Inhale through the nose, exhale through the mouth. Clear your toes. Let's press back up to downward facing dog. So at any time it's too much downward facing, we're going to be doing all kinds of planks. You need to take a break, roll your wrists out, that's fine. The other thing you can do this work on fists with straight wrists. But if you can manage it, palms, fingers are wide, and there's a slight bend in your elbow. Okay, this time what we're going to do is we're going to come to our downward facing dog. We're going to lift the right leg high and shift forward to that three-legged dog, or a one-legged plank. And I'm going to bring my knee to my elbow, right knee, right elbow, and then I'm going to lower it to the mat and lift it up. Lower lift, slow, four more, three more. Big exhale on the exertion, two more, last one, press back downward facing dog, other side. Lift the left leg high, shift forward to one-legged plank, bring your knee to your elbow, and slide it down to your wrist. So you're going to lower and lift, and lower and lift, for four, for three, for two, and one. Come down onto your knees, make a fist, and just roll your wrists from side to side. Great. Swing your legs out in front. We'll do some stretches in between. Lie flat, bring your arms up overhead. Bump your hips to the left, walk your feet to the right, take your left foot, cross it over your right foot, and reach your arms over to the right and pull on your left wrist with your right hand. And now try to drop the left hip down. Point your toes. Pull and release, and then go to the other side. I'm gonna bump my hips to the right. Bring my feet to the left. Pick my right foot up and bring it over top of my left. So I'm trying to make like a banana, like a C curve. I'm grabbing my right wrist with my left hand. And I'm breathing here. So don't forget to breathe. Inhale here, point your toes, exhale. Bend your knees, roll onto your back. Now roll to your side, press yourself up, come to a standing position, and take your block. So, I'm gonna take my block, put it on my left thigh, and bring my left elbow onto this block. And I'm gonna trap it here. And I'm going to bring my right hand to my hip. And I'm going to open up out to the side and come forward. So it's kind of like tree pose. I want you to pull up with your knee, press down with your elbow, and engage that side body oblique. We'll do two more on this side. Inhale, open. Exhale, close. My fingertips are pointing straight up. Pause to the side. Stand up nice and tall, and let's switch sides. So the block is long ways. I guess if you don't have the block, you could lift your knee up or just simulate, but it really helps to have something that you can track here. So I'm pulling up with my knee and pressing down with my elbow. I'm gonna open to the side and close. What I really want you to do is focus on that oblique on the side where your block is. Inhale, open. Exhale, close. Inhale, open. Exhale, close. We've got two more. Keep the knee lifted. Try to get the knee to be about hip height. Last time, open. Last time, close. Take the block in your hand. Make some circles with your hips. Great. We're going to do warrior three. We're going to look like a capital letter T. Then we're going to shift forward and stand up to a one-legged mountain pose. So level one, you're not going to use the block at all, or you can hold the block in your hands. Level two, you're going to stand on the block on one leg, on one foot. So I'm going to demonstrate level one first. Step forward onto one foot. Pop up onto the toes of the back foot. Hold the block overhead. Hug your bicep in by your ears and just tilt forward. Warrior three, one with the capital letter T. You want to use your abs. So here you are here, and then you're going to lift and come to a one-legged mountain without falling. So squeeze the block in your hands. If it's too much, bring the block to your chest. Warrior three. Chin is away from the chest. You're maybe lifting the block up overhead. So you keep doing that. If you want to make it more difficult, you can stand on the block with one leg. You're going to lift to your one-legged warrior three, one-legged mountain pose, and you're going to shift forward to warrior three. One-legged mountain, hands can come through heart center, hands, arms can be out in front, toes are down, heel is out. Wherever you are, let's do two more. Nice big inhales. Swing it to warrior three for your exhale. Inhale, lift, use your abdominals. Last time, sweep to warrior three. And then come to the other side. So other side, I'm gonna lose the block. I'm gonna step forward with my right foot this time. My left foot is back. I'm gonna pop up. I'm gonna bring my hands to heart center. And I'm just gonna come down to warrior three. Hands are gonna stay at heart center. I'll show the progression. One-legged mountain, swing it back, warrior three. Use your abs. Make it more difficult, arms are extended. One-legged mountain, swing it to warrior three. Drop the hip, lift the heels. A little bit more difficult, hold the block in between the hands. Maybe lifting up overhead and swinging out in front. Whatever you want to do, whatever helps you maintain your balance. And most more difficult is standing on the block and going to our one-legged mountain to warrior three. Couple more good ones. Use your abdominals to swing the leg through. Okay, you guys, do one more. Good, and then come down onto your mat. All right. Make sure you're breathing, okay? In through the nose and out through the mouth. And the exhales are always on the exertion with our core and abdominal work. Okay, so take your block and bring it about halfway back onto your mat. We're gonna do a plank series. So we're gonna be in plank, and all we're gonna do is reach back and take this block and bring it over to the other side, put the hand down, take the block, and put it back to the other side. But what I want you to do is shift forward so that the heels are over the toes, legs are straight as possible, slight bend in the arms, and see if you can have the hips not move as you pass that block from the left to the right. You've got to use your abdominals. You can always come down onto your knees. Pass the block, bring the hand down. Pick up the block, pass it underneath the body, put the hand back down. So you're either on your toes, or you're on your knees. So keep doing a couple more. Inhaling and exhaling. And then slowly release and lower down. Just come to your knees and catch your breath. Okay. So you can press the block away and come back up. We're going to do shoulder taps. So level one, you're going to be down here on your knees. You're going to lower your hips. Your toes can be down on the mat. I want your wrists directly underneath the shoulders, and I want you to press through your hands and don't through your spine. No sinking chest. And you're just going to lift one hand and tap the opposite shoulder. There's level one. Level two, lift those back knees. Bring shift the weight forward, the sheath, the heels are over the toes. So let's do four, three, two, and one. Great, come to your knees. Let's just do a lateral stretch. Oh, put one hand down, reach the other arm up. Right arm down, left arm up. Oh. And let's twist. Hand to the opposite knee, then twist and look back over that shoulder. Dial it around. And let's do another wrist stretch. So make a fist. Bring the arms out in front and just make figure eights. I'm getting warm. Okay, so coming to the side, we're just gonna do a gate to a side plank. So gate pose. So my right knee is bent, my left leg is out, my toes are facing forward. I'm gonna bring my left arm down onto this left leg, reach my right arm up, lateral stretch. Then I'm going to bring my right arm down to the floor, onto the mat, and I'm going to just keep my leg down and lift over. We'll do modified side plank in a minute. So gate pose, bring your back, left shoulder forward, hand down, arm up. One more time. Good. And bring that right hand down. So the right knee is down, the right hand is down. You want the wrist to be right underneath the shoulder. We're going to do a modified side plank. So pull the back shoulder blade forward. Bring your chin in line with your chest. Level one, here is our modified side plank. You can bring your arm up, or you can bring your hand on your hip. And you can, level two, lift and lower the leg, or just keep the leg lifted. Leg lifted, arm lifted would make it even more difficult. Try to stack everything. Hips are stacked and shoulders are stacked. Option to bend the knee, grab for the back foot, give it a little kick, and a nice big stretch. You can always stay right down here in modified side plank. When we're in a side plank, what we don't want to do is let the bottom ribs collapse. We want to pull everything up. So we're trying to do that banana arc, like when we're doing reclining palm tree on that side. Let's do the other side. So now my left knee is down, my right leg is straight, my left hand is directly underneath my left shoulder. I'm gonna pull that left shoulder under and kind of tack it back. So level one, you can stay right here, but pull up on that lower side body so you're rounding through the upper ribs. So same thing on the other side, whatever you want to do. You can lift and lower the leg, you can bring the arm up, you can hold it up, and you can stretch. As long as you're breathing, keep breathing. Just hold and lift. An inhale. And an exhale. Great, and let's come down. Your option here is to do a child's pose, or cat-cow. Cat-cow, we arch the spine, lift the chin, and then exhale, dome to the spine, bring the chin to the chest. Your other option is just to go right into cat-cow, which, child's pose. Knees would be wide and big toes touch, and reach forward. Take two breaths here. Inhaling and exhaling. And then grab your block for dead bug and swing through, swing your legs through. You're going to lay long on your mat. Your head and shoulders are going to stay on the mat. You're going to take the block, and just like we did when we were standing, we're going to make the take the block long ways and trap it between the thigh and the elbow on the same side. Then you're going to, I've got the block trapped at my left knee, left thigh to my left elbow. My right arm is long, and my right leg is long. I'm going to lift up. I'm going to touch and come down. Or you can go elbow to knee and reach long. Elbow to knee and reach long. Or reach for the toes and reach long. The trick is you want to keep pulling this thigh in and pressing the elbow away. Let's do two more. Really pull it in. Really trap that block. Press the elbow towards the thigh. Pull the thigh back and then release. And let's go to the other side. Dead bug. Okay. Block is trapped between my elbow and my thigh. I have my other arm extended, my other leg extended. So I'm in reverse tabletop with one leg on this side. I'm going to bend and extend, elbow to knee, or reach for the toes, pull it in, big breaths. Inhale as you extend, exhale as you crunch. Let's do four more. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Keep pulling it in. Don't lose that block trap on that side. Last one. And release. Just hold your block, windshield wiper your knees from side to side. Okay, and roll yourself over onto your side. So now we're going to do side plank, but it's not going to be modified. So your option here with side plank is, this time rather than being on our forearm with one knee down, we're going to be on our hand, and the option is to have one knee down. So I've got my left arm down, right underneath my left shoulder. I'm going to twist, I'm going to draw that shoulder blade and wrap it around and push it forward so that my bottom pec comes forward. My right hand is on my hip. So you can stay right here with the bottom knee bent, or you can stagger your feet and have two straight legs. And the same thing as when we were in modified side plank, you don't want the side body to collapse. So you really have to press up with that bottom hand. And the other option is to stack both feet on top of each other. I'm going to stagger my feet. Your options here are level two. You can lift the top leg. You can go into tree pose. You can do anything that you like to do here in side plank. But wherever you are, whether you have a bottom knee down or you're still on your hand, let's do some thread the needle. So we're going to take that top arm and we're going to sweep it underneath. And then we're going to lift and open. And as we sweep it down, we're going to lift the hips and have there be a little pike. And then we're going to lift. We're going to do two more. We're going to thread the needle. We're going to lift the hips and pike. Last one. And lift. And release. We're going to go to the other side. Right away. Shake out that wrist. Get all the wrist stuff done. Then we'll be off of our wrists for the rest of the session. So my right hand is down. I want to make sure that everything is set, that their wrist, elbow, shoulder. I'm going to pull that back shoulder blade forward. I'm going to lift my top arm up and come to a side plank. So remember, you can stack your feet. You can stagger your feet. I like to stagger my feet and keep bringing and pulling up with my right hip up towards the sky. And now I'm going to thread the needle. So I'm going to take that left arm and thread it under and lift it up. We're doing four. As I thread it under, I'm piking my hips up slightly. Inhale at the top and exhale. Use your breaths. Don't forget to breathe. Level two, do reach for your toes, do your tree pose, do whatever it is that you like to do inside plank, and then slowly release and come down. Let's do a quick forearm stretch. So I'm gonna cross my left arm over my right, sitting down on my knees. I'm gonna bring my hands towards each other, relax my shoulders, and I'm just gonna draw in and draw out. I'll turn sideways so you can see what I'm doing. Trying to keep my palms together, hands in, hands extend out. I'm gonna switch sides, bring the other hand on top. Relax my shoulders away from my ears. Inhale, exhale as I extend out. Inhale, they come in. Exhale out. Inhale and exhale. Hey, I don't know about you, but I'm working up a sweat. Might just be because I'm in this hot garage. Okay, we're gonna be in a tabletop position, all four kneeling, point kneeling position. I'm gonna put my right knee on the block. I'm gonna extend my left leg back, and my hands are on the mat. So I'm pressing through my hands and I'm doming through my spine. No collapsed chest here. And I'm gonna lift my back foot up off the mat. So my right knee is on the block, and I'm lifting my left leg up high and trying to stack my hips and keep my hips in line. So I'm gonna lift and lower. You can stay right here, or you can extend the right arm out with the thumbs up and lift and lower here. If you want to make it more difficult, pick the back toes of the knee that's on the block up off the mat and work real slow. Lift and lower. More stability, bring your toes down onto the mat. Just do two more. And release, and bring your hands down onto the mat, and we'll do the other side. So bring your block underneath the other knee. Now make sure you're set up properly. So you want your hands to be under, right directly underneath your shoulders. Reach that back leg back. Square your hips. So I'm gonna drop my right hip because my left knee is on the block. I'm gonna extend my left arm out, lift my toes up, and find my stability here. You can stay right here. If you want to make it more difficult, you can lift and lower. You can sweep the arm in and out. Whatever it is that you want to do here. Remember, toes down of the foot on the block is going to make it easier. Toes lifted is going to make it more difficult. So you can lift and lower. You can even do bird dog. Real slow. Knee to the elbow and then reach. Knee kisses the elbow and then reach. We didn't do that on the other side. But what I really want to do is show you guys a whole bunch of abdominal work, and you can break and pause here. I want you to show a whole bunch of different yoga abdominal moves that you can do. So hopefully you find something that really speaks to you and you can stick with to work on your core strength. Okay, so now we're going to come to a forearm plank. And level one, you're just going to hold your forearm plank. So your forearms are flat. Your hands are flat, like a number 11. You're gonna reach one leg back and reach the other leg back, and then you're gonna press through your elbows from your elbows to the tips of your fingers to round through your spine. Pull your belly button in, knit your low ribs in. Level one, you're gonna stay here. Level two, alternating knee taps. Pull your belly in and make the knee tap from your abdominals, not from your legs. Double knee taps. I'm going to show you guys a bunch of things you can do here. Keep going. Double knee taps. Other option, hip dips. Drop your hips, roll to one side of each. You can roll both of your feet to the left. Drop your hips down. Other option, stay right here in forearm plank and lift and reach. You might have to widen your stance. Just punch one hand forward. Just tap your fingers forward. Try not to move your hips. Big breaths. You breathe out as you reach forward. Draw your belly button in. Squeeze your hips. Squeeze your glutes. Do two more good ones. and then break. Whew. Come onto your knees. Actually, let's come down and do a Sphinx. So just come down onto your belly and your forearms, just like we were in forearm plank. But your elbows are underneath your shoulders. Your tops of your feet are on your mat. Your legs are long. Your pelvis is heavy. Draw your belly button into your spine, like you're trying to get it away from your shirt. Tuck your chin and lengthen through the crown of your head, traction your elbows down towards your hips. And with your hips down, try to lengthen through your spine. And press back, child's pose, knees are wide. So actually, let's keep the knees together and bring the forehead to the mat and reach the hands back, be more of a stretch on the low back. Embryo pose. Okay, slowly rise, find your block, bring it in between your thighs. We're gonna come to a hovering tabletop. So I think I'm gonna face the camera and do it this way. So my hands are directly underneath my shoulders, my toes are curled under. I'm gonna lift my hips, I'm gonna lift my knees a few inches up off the mat. I'm gonna dip my hips to the left and I'm gonna pull my knees up towards the sky and come to the center. And I'm gonna drop my hips down to the right and pull my knees up. So I want you guys to cycle back and forth, side to side. So I'm dropping them to the left, my hips to the left. I'm lifting my knees up and then coming through the center. It's like an accordion. I'm squeezing the block, drop and pull. Knees are lifted. Do a couple more on each side. Don't forget to breathe. Inhale and exhale. And then release. Okay, keep your block right off to the side. I want you to lie onto your back. Your block is going to go in between your knees. We're going to do some transverse abdominis work. That's the lowest abs, our deepest abs. It's the abdominal part that's below the belly button. So bring your block in between your knees. And bring your feet down onto the mat. So we're just gonna do some spine extension and flexion. So arch your spine really, really big. So drop your tailbone down. Make a big belly arch so that a mouse could run underneath your spine. And then imprint your spine, tuck your tailbone, and get all of your low back and your spine down on the mat. So arch and imprint. It's like a rolling bridge with the hips down. Arch and imprint. Roll the spine. Good. Now to find a neutral spine, we're going to find halfway in between there. Half imprinted and half arched. So that if you were to take your fingers, and try to slide them under your back, you'd only be able to go up to like maybe your second knuckle. And that's about where we want to be. So I want you to bring your arms out like a T with your palms face down. So your arms are an extension of your shoulder. Find that neutral spine. First, draw the belly button into the spine. Knit the low ribs down like someone's in front of you, like a little kid, and you're like, I'm gonna punch you in the stomach, and you're like, oh, you have to bracing yourself, right? So doing a little abdominal bracing, and then lift your feet up off the mat, and then take your hands and bring them behind your hamstrings. I want your knees to be far away from your face to the point where your arms are straight, and then bring your arms back out to a T. Now your knees are directly over your hips. I want you to drop your knees over to one side to about 45 degrees. Press down with your hands and then come back up to the center. And then drop your knees about 45 degrees over and then squeeze the block and come back to the center. So this would be level one. Level two, when you roll over to the side, you're gonna extend your legs and then bend and come back to the center. And then tick-tock over to the other side, extend your legs. You can do the whole thing with your legs straight. You can tick-tock through center. So we want to have that neutral spine, so it's not imprinted and there's not a big arch. You go nice and slow. Exhale as you come up. Squeeze the block. And then go over to the other side on the inhale. And then squeeze the block to come up to the center. Do one more to the right. Last one to the left. Come back to the center, bring your feet down, just lift and lower your hips. I'm gonna do one more thing right here. So keep your arms out like a T. Find that neutral spine, so it's halfway between imprinted and a big arch. And then bring your legs back up to reverse tabletop. If you need to, bring your hands back behind your hamstrings and release your thighs away so that your knees are, if you're in a room with mirrors, I want your knees to be over your hips. If you're not in a room with mirrors, most people tend to pull their knees in real close to their belly, almost like they're about to, and then they completely have an imprinted spine. I want you to release it away. It's much more difficult. Arms are out, palms are facing down. Squeeze the block, dip your toes in the water, come back up. Dip your toes in the water, come back up. Dip it and lift it. If you want to feel that transverse abdominis working, put your fingertips on that, on the abs below your belly button. Make sure you're breathing. Dip the toes in the water and lift. Dip and lift. Couple more and then release. Oof. Hold your block, windshield wiper, your knees from side to side. I told you this wasn't going to be like a sleepy yoga. This is yoga abs, yoga core. Okay. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to do a block track. So you're going to take your block, and you're going to put it in between your knees, but I want a lot of the block facing your body so that two-thirds of the block is out and one-third of the block is being held in between your knees. Bring your hands behind your head, fingertips behind your ears, but don't clasp your hands together. So squeeze your knees together and hold the block. Inhale and lift your head and your neck and your shoulders up off the mat. And twist. I'm going to twist and bring my left elbow to the block, and I'm going to trap it by pulling my right knee in and my left elbow out. And I'm going to extend my left leg long and then bring it in, and I'm going to switch sides. So level one, if you're finding this is really difficult, just bring the elbow to the block and then come back to the center and lower down and lift and twist and try and trap the block between the elbow and the knee and come down. Level two, you're going to lift and twist and extend the leg and come up. Your option is to come down in the middle and then lift and go to the other side. Your third option is to stay lifted. The chin is off the chest. You are looking up at the ceiling and you're lifting your collarbone straight up and you're twisting and you're trapping that block. Remember, level one, if you can just twist, lower, release, lift, twist, maybe just trap the block and come in. Trust me, it gets easier the more you do it. However, if you want to make it more difficult, release your knees further away from you. Bridge the gap by bringing the shoulders up. Get more of the spine up off the mat. Lift and twist and really lift and release that leg away that's trapping the block. Couple more, each side. Inhale through the center. Exhale as you trap the block and extend the leg. And release, lift and lower the hips. Okay, set your block off to the side. Let's just do a quick stretch. So come down onto your belly. We're just gonna do a floor bow breakdown. Come to the tops of your feet, extend your arms out long. I'm gonna reach back and grab my right foot with my right hand and bring my chin down to the mat. I'm pressing the top of my left foot down and I'm gonna lift my right arm up and kick, my left arm up and kick into my right foot. My right hand is kicking, my right foot is kicking in my right hand. Tuck your chin and then release and do the other side. So first bring your knees together so they don't flare out. bend your left knee, reach back with your left hand, grab onto the top of the left foot. Inhale, drive the hip down and just kick the foot into the hand and see if you can lift the knee up off the mat without it flaring out to the side. Option to lift that front arm, tuck your chin, lengthen to the top of your head. And then slowly release. Windshield wiper, feet from side to side. Let's do both. Bend both knees, reach back. Chin is on the mat where you kiss your mat. Squeeze your knees together. Dorsiflex the ankle. That means the toes are reaching towards the knees. Take a nice big inhale. And then on the exhale, kick and gently lift the knees. Drive the pelvis down. Draw your shoulder blades back. Maybe lift your chin, look up if it feels good on your neck. And try to lift your feet really high. And then slowly release. And again, you can rinse your wipe of the legs back and forth, side to side. And press yourself back for a quick child's pose. And then make your way, your way to a seated position for Navasana, boat pose. We're almost done. A couple more poses. Your abs are going to thank me. So you're going to sit up nice and tall. You're leaning back slightly, but not even quite 45 degrees. My toes are lifted, and I've got my hands behind my hamstrings. So I'm going to pull with my arms, my hands, and bend my elbows. Squeeze my shoulder blades together. The trick with Navasana boat pose is you want to stay with a flat back. A lot of people collapse and they begin to round when they get tired, and that's okay. But when we start to get tired, we're going to go back to our starting position. So I want everybody to stay right here. This is going to be level one. Nice big breaths. You can extend one arm and extend the other arm. Torso doesn't move. Nothing moves. The only thing I moved was I brought my hands from behind my hamstrings. If at any time I start to collapse, I'm going to bring my hands back. I'm going to pull on the back of my hamstrings, and I'm going to find that straight back again. Level one, stay here. Level two, pick up one foot, pick up the other foot. You're in tabletop, but I'm still squeezing my shoulder blades together. My chest is lifted. My chin is off my chest. Now from here, you can straighten your arms. You can straighten your legs. And if you start to collapse, you're going to come back down, bring the heels down, pull, lift, squeeze the shoulder blades together. And that's one great tip. Keep the shoulder blades squeezing the whole time. No matter what you do, no matter how you reach, you're squeezing those shoulder blades together behind you. Everybody come back up to our starting position. Bring your hands to heart center. Thumbs are going to stay right on the sternum. Twist and bring your right elbow down towards the mat. Come to center. Twist and bring the other elbow down towards the mat. So the option here, pull the chest forward, pull the thumbs into the chest. Option here is to squeeze your legs together and lift your legs up into reverse tabletop. Maybe straighten the legs. Or just stay right here. Drag your heels down like you're pulling them towards your glutes and twist from side to side. Inhale in the center. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. And let's break. So slowly lower down onto your back. Bend your knees. Bring your feet flat. Let's take bridge pose. So wiggle your shoulder blades together and walk your feet close enough to your glutes so that you can tickle your heels with your fingertips. Once you're there, bend your elbows, point your fingers straight up towards the sky, squeeze your shoulder blades together, and lift up into bridge, and lower. So you're just lifting your hips, and you're lowering. If your block is nearby, really, really great to put a block in between your knees for bridge pose. It just hugs everything in. Everything in. It forces you to have your feet be in alignment. It keeps your hips in alignment. So just lift and lower, and then maybe stay up there nice and high and bridge. I like to bring my hands flat, squeeze your knees together, lift your hips, squeeze your knees together, and then press them away from your face. Lift your chin away from your chest, and then slowly lower down. And set your block off to the side. extend your legs out long. Let's hug the right knee in and just do a supine twist. Right knee falls to the left, arm is out. So the extended leg, lengthen that in your inhale. Pull your belly button into your spine on your exhale. See if that deepens your twist. When you're ready, roll onto your back and go to the other side. Hug the other knee in to wiggle moving pose. And take it to a supine twist. You can always do eagle legs, whatever feels good. You can bend both knees and bring your knees over to one side. There's a big difference. Let's just twist and stretch out that whole core. We're stretching out our low back, stretching out our obliques, all through the abs. It's gotta feel good. Stretch here, big breaths. And then roll onto your back. Bend your knees, bring your feet flat. Roll your knees over to one side, press yourself up to a seated position. We're gonna do string of pearls a couple times, and then we'll do a little bit of shavasana. So, this is very difficult with your legs extended and your heels down. Easier if you have a little bit of bend in your knees. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a lot of rounding through the spine. We're gonna start with a straight spine and our arms right out in front. We're gonna take a nice big inhale here. Plug your shoulder blades into the back wall. So if you reach your fingertips forward, first do that and then hug your shoulder blades together and squeeze your shoulders right. You wanna have a nice flat back. So we're gonna inhale here and bring our arms up overhead. And then an exhale, I'm gonna scoop it around my spine. And I'm gonna lay my bottom, my low back, middle back, and I'm reaching for my toes the whole time and I'm carving and scooping out my belly. And I'm gonna lay all the way down, reach back, bring my thumbs to the floor, and I'm gonna bring my, as I lift my arms up, I'm gonna lift my head up, I'm gonna bring my chin to my chest, and I'm gonna do a reverse curl. I'm gonna take the top of my shoulders, then my upper back, my middle back, my lower back, and I'm gonna try to keep my heels down on the ground. I'm gonna reach all the way past my feet, and bring my forehead down towards my knees, and then I'm gonna sit up nice and tall and start up with a flat back. So remember, you can do this with your knees bent, heels are down, toes are up, or you can do this with your legs straight. So inhale, arms up. Exhale, hollow scoop. It's like someone could put a Sharpie on your spine and you're laying back on a white piece of paper and you're lowering back one vertebra at a time. And then you come all the way back and take an inhale here. And then exhale, lift the arms, chin to the chest, pull your ribs back, pull your stomach back, pull your belly button back, pull everything, C-curve, 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 round all the way forward. And then sit up nice and tall. Let's do it one more time. Inhale, nice big straight flat back. Exhale, scoop, scoop, scoop. Belly button scoop, like you're trying to zip up skinny jeans, but reach for your toes the whole time. Reach, 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 reach. Chin is on the chest. One vertebra at a time. Ooh. All the way back. Breathing the whole time. Did I forget to mention that? Inhale. Exhale, chin to the chest. No momentum. No momentum. Reach, 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 reach. Round and reach. And let's stay forward fold. Oh. Rounded spine. Slowly bring your hands to your mat. Bend your knees. Grab onto your block if you've got it. Bring it underneath your knees, middle height. Lower down to one forearm and the other forearm. And we're just gonna hit shavasana right here with some support underneath the backs of the knees if this feels good for you. If it doesn't, you can always take it out, put it underneath your low back. Sacrum, or put it underneath your head. Oh. So we worked the abdominals. pretty good session of abs and core. So important to do this entire abdominal core area. So good for hip stability, power in sports, power in your golf swing, power in your tennis swing, pickleball, running, biking, everything. Our abs help keep us upright and they support our spine. Really important for us to not lose our abdominal strength. So I'm going to leave you here in Shavasana and let you rest your abdominal core section. Hope you check out some of my other videos. I'm trying to do very specific areas of the body with concentrated classes for those areas. When you're ready to come out, bend your knees, bring your feet flat, send your arms up overhead. Roll to one side. Use your body, bicep as a pillow. And press yourself up. Thanks so much for going through my class. And I hope to see you again on the mat. Namaste. Have a great day.